Hi, my name is Bob Zolo of Agilent Technologies. Today I'd like to demonstrate to you the Agilent N6705B DC Power Analyzer. The DC Power Analyzer boosts the productivity of the R&D engineer by integrating into a single package multiple instrument functions. So for example, within this one instrument, you have up to 4 DC power supply outputs, and these are fully programmable outputs. You have a voltmeter, ammeter, oscilloscope, arbitrary waveform generator, and data logger. Today, during this demonstration, I'll be using 2 of the power supply outputs and the data logger function. The device under test that I'll be testing today is this CD-ROM drive out of a personal computer. And what I'm going to be doing is looking at how much power it draws by monitoring the current flowing into the device under test. Now, it requires 2 different supply voltages. Channel 1 will be programmed to 12 volts and supply the power to the motor that opens and closes the drive door as well as spins the disk. And channel 2 will be programmed to 5 volts, and that'll be powering the 5-volt logic. And we'll be able to see what happens as we open and close the drive door, how we can see the motor current as well as the 5-volt logic current. Now the first thing that I want to do is I need to set the outputs to the correct voltages. I've done that ahead of time. Again, channel 1 set to 12 volts and channel 2 set to 5 volts. So in order to test it, I have to turn it on, so I'll hit the all on button. Now the all on button allows me to turn all 4 outputs on simultaneously. So let me go ahead and do that, and you can see all the outputs have come on. Now this is a convenience feature, because if you're trying to turn 4 power supply outputs on simultaneously, you don't have to hit 4 buttons to do that, and when you hit the all on button, it's guaranteed that they all come on at the same time. Another capability associated with the all-on button is the ability to delay or sequence the outputs. So if you have a device under test, like an FPGA or something, that needs to have its core turned on before its auxiliary functions, you can program a delay time between the channels so that they come up in the proper order. But in this case, we just need them to come on at the same time and power up the device under test. Okay, so I'm all powered up and running, but what I really want to do is look at current versus time using the data logger as we open and close the drive door. So let me start the data logger. I have to push the button that says data logger, and now I get a screen, a grid that looks like an oscilloscope, and there's 2 traces on it. There's the green trace here, which is the 5-volt logic, the current flowing into the 5-volt logic, and the yellow trace, which is the current flowing into the 12 volts driving the motor. So when I hit the run stop button, that'll start the data logger, and now you can see the data's flowing. I've got the data logger set to 30 seconds. It can actually go for much longer than 30 seconds, but for purposes of this demonstration, I only have it set to 30 seconds. Now as I operate the drive door and I open it, you can see the current on the 12-volt line as the door opens, and if I hit the close button, you can see the current on the 12-volt line as the door closes, but you can also see some current on the 5-volt line, and the current there is actually the current being drawn by the 5-volt logic as it looks for the disk in the drive. There is no disk in here, but it is looking for one. Okay, so 30 seconds is up. It saved the file, and now you can see the waveforms. Now, once I have this data collected, I can do different things with it. I can save this picture as a bitmap, and I can import it into a report, or I can export the data as a CSV file and then analyze it with some other software, or I can interact with it directly on the screen of the instrument by pushing the data logger button again. I get some markers, and I can go ahead and use the markers and take measurements off of the data logger. Okay, so I want to run this one more time, and I want to try something as I'm running it. So in this case, as it's running, again, a 30-second data log, I can open the door, and there's the normal door open operation. I can close the door. There's the normal closed door operation. But this time, as the door opens, I'm going to hold it back as if there's something jamming the door. And I can actually measure the current, which is the stall current on the 12-volt line that drives the motor. So in this case, I'm able to look at the current and understand what happens when some kind of a fault condition occurs. Therefore, this allows me not only to analyze normal operation, but analyze abnormal operation or error conditions. So that was a quick demonstration of how you can use the DC analyzer to power a device under test and a data logger to make measurements on the device under test. Thank you.